Hello and welcome back to my channel. So today's tutorial, we're going to learn how to make this illustration in Adobe Illustrator in few simple steps. So let's just get started. First, let's create a new file. Go to File and then New. Let's make this 9 into 6 inches. That means it is in landscape orientation. Let's make this RGB for now. You can make it CMYK if you're going to print it. And here we choose 300 ppi and click create. So now I'll just go ahead and bring in my colors because then it'll be much easier. I'll go to my layers and there's a layer here. Just I'll copy the colors. Okay, I have my colors in here. I will leave more information about these colors in the description box. You can go pick it up from there. So first we're going to start with our trees and then slowly move in and create the rest of the artwork. Go to your ellipse tool. If you cannot see ellipse, right click and then ellipse tool. Let's just draw an elongated ellipse. Make sure you are not holding your shift key down. If you do, it will be a complete circle. Now let's make a little wider ellipse, something like this. And now a little bit more wider one. So this is not what I was looking for. So I'll just go back to my selection tool. Click and drag to make it a little more wider and place it like this. And this one, I want this wider as well. But I want it not just to go on one side, but on both sides. So I'm just going to hold my Option or Alt key down, click, and then drag, and it moves in both the directions. And let's just move this up a little bit. I'm not really happy with this one. So I'm just going to click on that, hold my Option key down, and drag it in a little bit. And now it's fine. Let's make this a little wide as well. Hold your Option, click, and drag. I think this should be fine. So click and select everything. And now go to your Pathfinder tool. That is, you can go to Window and then Pathfinder. Click on Unite. Your first tree is ready. Now we're going to color it something from a color palette. Let's make a similar one. I'm just going to hold my Option key down. Click and drag. And now this one, I'm going to mark it as this color. I do that by pressing I on my keyboard and it goes to the eyedropper tool, which you can find right here. And then I click on the color palette that I have and then it automatically colors it. But this one, we're going to make it a little smaller. So click, hold your shift key down and drag it in to make it a little smaller. But here, we're just going to adjust these edges a little bit. Go to your direct selection tool and click and drag to select these two points and drag it a little bit in. Yes, our two trees are ready. Just going to place them here. So this tree is going to be really behind the house, like you see here. So I would prefer to have it on a different layer. So I'm just going to do that. Click Ctrl X to cut and then create a new layer by going here. If you cannot see layers, go to Window and then Layer. So everything in here you can find under the Window section. So I'll just click on New Layer. I'm going to lock this layer, otherwise it's going to try and paste it over there. And press Ctrl or Command F to paste. Okay, now it's time to make the base this one so that we have an idea of where to place things. So as you can see, this is really on the top of all the elements. So I'm just going to go ahead and make one more layer. Let's lock this for now. Go to your ellipse tool and start making some ellipses. Let's make some in different sizes. You don't want a lot of deep curves here, so I'm just going to try and keep it as flat as I can. Now I'll go back to my selection tool and drag it out a little bit so that it's not that bad. Now select everything, go to your Pathfinder and click on Unite. And let's color this our color. And now if you want, you can modify this a little bit. For example, there are some, if you want this to be a straight line here, go to your direct selection tool. Click on them, you can either pull this out to make it a more rounded thingy or you can delete those anchor points to just give it a straight line. Let's pull this out, let's make this a little bit round by pulling this circle thingy out here. Okay, so our base is ready. Let's just keep it here, lock it because we'll be using it sometime later. Okay, now it's time to make the house. Let's create a new layer and then go to your rectangle tool, right click. Rectangle tool, and let's make a rectangle approximately of this size. And let's choose a color for that. Let's make it a little smaller. Now it's time to make a roof. Go to your pen tool, right click and click on pen tool. Just click and drag a little bit outside the square. And then almost to this end where it matches. And then let's take it all the way back and hold your shift key to make sure it's straight. Click and then come back and join this point right here. And let's color this roof. I know it looks a little weird now, but it's going to make sense after a while. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the layer with the tree right above the house so that we have something like this. And I'll move the layer that is the bottommost layer on the top so that it's always on the top. Just going to uncheck everything and adjust this a little bit. It is a little bigger. Okay. And then this one, I'm going to make it a little bigger so that it covers the bottom of the house. But this one, there's a gap there, so let me just move it. Okay, this seems fine. All right, so our base is ready. I think I would like to expand this a little bit. Okay, so let's just get started with making the branches and stuff. So go to your layer with the tree. Let's select a stroke color. This one. And in the line segment, just click, hold your shift key down and drag to make a line. And let's make a similar branches. That is, click, hold your shift key down and make a line. And it makes a very nice 45 degree angle. Just scroll inside and see that the line settings are set to rounded cap. If it is not, you can go to your selection tool and hold your shift and select these line segments. Go to stroke, again window stroke, click on 5-point rounded caps and rounded corners and you should be good. We can do the same thing on this side as well. So go to your layer with the yellow tree, click on the line segment and let's just choose the color here. Okay, so now it's time to add some pattern on this tree. So go to your ellipse tool and then let's choose the color which I've chosen here. Okay. And then hold your shift key down, click and drag to make a circle. And this one I've kept at 1.5. Let's make a few more circles with different sizes. Let's do the same thing for this side as well, but before that, go to your tree and then make the circles. Okay, now it's time to move on to our house. The first thing we have to do is make a door. So go to your rounded rectangle here and go to your house, click and drag to make a rounded rectangle. Now it's time to add some color. So I'm just going to go stroke and click on none and go to my fill color. And I'll show you another method in which you can add color to something. So double click and you can type in the hex code here, which I will leave in the description box. So you can just bring them in and paste it here and click OK. And then it will have a different color right here. So now we have to add a shadow to it. So click on it, hold your option key down, shift key down and drag to make a tiny thing like this. And now we're going to change the color of the background thing to a darker color. And this one will remain like this. This is too wide. I'm just going to click and drag it back in to make it a little lighter. But as you can see, not so much. So just drag and so that it covers that part. So your door is ready as well. And now let's go ahead and make those patterns that we did. So you can go to the rectangle tool again, click and drag to make these tiny blobs. Let's choose the color that we picked already. Okay, and let's make a few more of this in varied sizes. Next, we'll go ahead and make the same thing for the bottom layer. So go to the bottommost layer here. You can either go to your rectangle tool or you can use your paintbrush tool. I'll just use my paintbrush tool right here. And now for the color, I'll click I and select this color, but I'm going to double click and make it a little lighter by dragging this thing up here and click OK. And now use your paintbrush tool and drag to make some lines like this. All right, so we are done with that. And next up is the rest of the shadows. So let's go to our house. And this is where it comes in. So this house is layered between these two things. So this tree is really far away, so we are not going to put a shadow of the house over here. We'll just put the shadow of the tree. Okay, next up, we're going to make the shadow right below the roof. So go to your rectangle tool and go as close as you can. And you can see these pink lines, which help you actually guide. If you don't see this, go to View and then Smart Guides. Now let's go ahead, click and drag and make a rectangle so that this should intersect with kind of this line right here. Okay, that's fine. Let's color this rectangle the color of our ground here. So press I and select that color. And now we'll make shadow. So go to your pen tool. But before that, select black in here and then go to your pen tool. And make sure you always cross this path right here. So I'll just go ahead and click and make sure I'm going through that path and click and click and close the loop. And now this one, we're going to reduce the transparency. If you cannot see that here, you can go to Window and then Transparency. Let's reduce this about 29, not 30%. So if you're not happy with the distance of the shadow, you can go back to your direct selection tool. You can click and then drag it in like this. And then make sure you can drag it here as well. These are tips to edit something once you're actually finished working on it and you don't want to start from scratch. Okay, so our shadow is ready as well. And let's move these things a little bit, because they're very close to the top. So now the last bit, that is adding the clouds. So it's pretty simple. Go to your rounded rectangle tool. Let's click and make a cloud. And let's give this the color that you've already chosen. And now if you go to your selection tool, you'll see these round things. So click and drag them inside to make them completely round. I'll just reduce the size a bit. Okay, and you can make more of these over here. All right, so this is basically how you do this illustration, and I hope you liked this tutorial. And if you did, please give me a thumbs up and let me know if you have any questions regarding Illustrator or Photoshop, and I'll try to answer them in my next video. And once you have this ready, you can use this, because it's in a vector format, you can actually scale them. Like you can select everything and then scale them as huge or as tiny as you want. And then you can use these things, the illustrations that you drew right now, to upload to sites like Redbubble and Society6. And you can also convert them into patterns. But just make sure you export it as a PNG and not as a JPEG, because you want to get rid of the background. Okay, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.